Hello, welcome to another edition of Currently in Quincy. I'm Joe Catalano, and on today's program, we get to check in with folks from the Wollaston Garden Club. They're having their big annual holiday greens sale tomorrow. We'll get a little preview. First, though, we'll check out the weather and the news for you this morning. Currently in Quincy, we've got brilliant sunshine out there. It's kind of brisk, 46 degrees right now. It'll get a few degrees warmer than that this afternoon with abundant sunshine. Chilly night coming up tonight. Lows will drop off into the low to mid 30s, and we have a cooler weekend on tap for tomorrow. Lots of sunshine, only into the mid 40s, and a few degrees cooler than that on Sunday with sunshine. Mix of clouds and sun on Monday with a high barely 40 degrees. Again, 46 with sunshine in Quincy right now. In the news today, public hearings will be held soon regarding plans by the MBTA to lease out their parking lot at the North Quincy station for a large mixed-use development project. The City Council recently agreed to create a transit-oriented development district on the 7-acre site, but as Rob Stevens from the Quincy Planning Department explains, that in no way means the project is a done deal.
One of the goals that any developer developing on any of the T stations should have is to address traffic access and circulation. I think this building, this project right here in downtown, traffic didn't go away, but I feel a little bit safer pulling into the T station driveway right here in Quincy Center now that there's a signalized light and, you know, pedestrian cross signals. You know, whereas before it was one crosswalk and you took your life into your own hands. I think that's the intent of that goal number 6. For any future developers on the T stations, we expect them to look, analyze, and propose solutions to addressing traffic access and circulation.
Now, the MBTA wants to enter into a 99-year lease with a development firm that would build about 600 apartments with ground-level retail space and an 852-space parking garage to replace the parking lot. The project needs extensive city and state approval, and construction's not expected to begin until early 2018. With the future of the Quincy Masonic Temple in Quincy Center still in question, its members have decided to give up their liquor license. Quincy Health Commissioner Drew Shealy says the Masons determined that they no longer needed the year-round license.
The Masonic Temple, they're not going to renew their license next year. So
really?
We'll end up taking that back. They used it mainly for the shows that they did at
yes.
the temple. The Masonic Temple, that group, it's not a Greek. They don't go in there to drink or anything like that. It's not a club like you'd have up at the Elks or some of these other places. They basically had the alcohol license just for the shows that they did there. Mm-hmm. So Johnny Gillis, they used to come up for one-day licenses all the time. And Johnny Gillis, when one became available, a full one, said, why don't you just have it? That way you'll have it. And now with everything that's gone on, they're still not sure what's going on there. They're just, you know what, we're just going to turn it in and we'll go back to the one-days if we end up in a place or if we stay there. So they're all done.
The historic temple was heavily damaged by a 3-alarm fire over 3 years ago. Lodge members have been trying to reach an agreement with developers who would renovate the building and then share it with the Masons while converting it into office space or perhaps a small hotel. But so far, no agreements have been announced. City of Quincy has its first full-time substance abuse coordinator. Laura Martin has been hired to oversee the city's efforts to combat substance abuse and the opioid overdose epidemic. Martin is a former prosecutor in the Norfolk County District Attorney's Office, where she helped substance abusers with jail alternative programs. She was recognized by the Quincy Drug Court for working with victims and their families, as a member of the Mayor's Substance Abuse Task Force and the Quincy Anti-Drug Coalition. Her $75,000 annual salary will be funded with revenue from the new medical marijuana dispensary on Rashudi Drive as part of its host agreement with the city. Martin did lose her brother to an overdose in 2004. Looks like the new Walk of Names in front of Quincy City Hall will not be completed by the end of the year. Quincy Mayor Thomas Koch explains that there's been a mix-up with the new bricks that are needed to complete that project.
The status of that is the bricks, there was a mess-up in the order between the contractor and the vendor. So the name bricks are fine. It's the matching bricks that fill the space evidently were, the batches were made but then sold off to somebody else, even though our contractor had it lined up. So a little bit of a miscue there, which teaches us as we go forward with the Adams Green, we're going to make sure that we have liquidated damages and other legal protections in the contracts going forward, whether it's for brick or granite work or other. So it looks like it probably won't be done till the spring now.
Koch says cold weather will prevent workers from installing the brick pavers, but he says all 4,300 bricks that were originally purchased back in 1992 for $50 a piece will be replaced with new bricks. Owners of the original bricks have been given several opportunities to get them back. Mayor says any original bricks that are not picked up soon will be discarded. Now that you're up to date with weather and news, let's check out our programming lineup for later on today here on Quincy Access Television. Please join us at 4 o'clock for an At the Library concert series with the return of Boston Road. It's a replay of this program currently in Quincy today at 5 o'clock. Then at 6 o'clock, Sound Advice with attorney Tom Williams.
Hello, folks. I'm attorney Tom Williams, and welcome to Sound Advice.
FYI, at 6:30 from the Quincy Health Department today, it's Holiday Blues. The latest edition of Quincy in Focus, 7 o'clock on Channel 8. 7:30, you find out what's happening at your library for the month of December.
Hello, and welcome.
This year's Quincy Christmas Parade, replayed for you tonight at 9 o'clock. And at the Library Concert Series at 10:30, featuring the Doug McDonald Band. And at 11, it's Penny Dreadful's Shilling Shockers. Check out Channel 11 every day. You'll learn about different Quincy City departments and committee activities. It all starts at 5:30 with Quincy in Focus. City View with Quincy Mayor Thomas Koch at 6 p.m. 6:30 FYI, the Quincy Health Department Personal Care Product Safety is the topic this evening. In case you missed it, the Quincy Christmas Parade, 7 o'clock on Channel 11. 8:30, the Norfolk County Prevention Coalition Program, The Sun Will Rise, the topic tonight. City View with the mayor again tonight at 9 on Channel 11. And at 9:30, it's at your library for the month of December. Get a complete program schedule over on our website. Just go to qatv.org and click on Program Schedule. And as always, please do like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter and catch our weekly ad in the Quincy Sun. Coming up, we'll take a look at some of the current events and happenings posted on our electronic bulletin board on Channel 8 for your information. That is coming your way in just 1 minute.
Today is December 2nd. On this day in 1867, Charles Dickens began his second American reading tour at Boston's Tremont Temple. An enthusiastic audience, which included literary stars Henry Wadsworth Longfellow and Ralph Waldo Emerson, seemed to have forgotten Dickens' widely known unflattering views of the United States, described in his book American Notes. A 55-year-old Dickens read selections from A Christmas Carol and The Pickwick Papers. Although Dickens was in declining health, he embarked on an ambitious schedule. 6 months later, having given more than 400 readings, Dickens returned to Boston once more before concluding his tour in New York City. He died 2 years later, having written 14 novels, several of which are classics of English literature. For more about this and other Mass Moments, go online to massmoments.org. Brought to you by the Massachusetts Foundation for the Humanities.
Welcome back. Here is a check of some of the current events and activities that are displayed right now on our electronic bulletin board on Channel 8 for your information. Christ Church on Quincy Avenue holding their annual Christmas fair. It's from 5 to 8 today and 9 to 3 tomorrow this year, featuring crafts, handmade items, jewelry, baked goods, the cookie walk, and a lot of candy, too. First Baptist Church of Wollaston Christmas Fair is today, 5 to 8, and tomorrow, 9 to 2, with baked goods, wreaths and greens, attic treasures, raffles, and a whole lot more, plus their amazing chili hot dogs. Sons of the American Legion tree lighting ceremony scheduled for tomorrow at 6 o'clock at Flags for Veterans Island at School in Pleasant Streets. Santa will be there, too, with candy canes and hot chocolate. All are welcome to attend. And Quincy Point Congregational Church inviting you to their Christmas tree lighting tomorrow. Everybody's invited to also join in their pizza making, singing Christmas carols, and watching Christmas-themed movies. The fun there starts at 4:30 tomorrow afternoon. Don't forget, if you have an event or an activity you'd like to promote, just visit our website at qatv.org and download a bulletin board request form. Just fill it out and send it in. Get your message up here on Channel 8, too. Coming up, we'll get a little preview of tomorrow's Wollaston Garden Club annual holiday greens sale at the Wollaston Congregational Church. That's next.
I'll never forget the day our landlord called and said, "Read your lease. No pets allowed." My owner tells him my dog ate the lease, but that didn't work. And now I'm stuck in a shelter. But this pit bull is ready for a new crib. I'm loving, loyal, and play well with others. So don't be intimidated by all my muscles, because the biggest one I have is my heart. That's right, I said it.
Hi, I'm Captain Tom Lyons with the Quincy Fire Department. We'd love to see you get through this holiday season without a tragic fire incident. Decorative lighting, candles, celebrations, and the start of heating season all increase the probability of fire. So please, do not overload electrical outlets or power strips. Discard any extension cord or decorative lighting sets with frayed cords or broken plugs. 28% of home electrical fire fatalities occur this way. Unattended burning candles account for 60% of all candle fires. Statistically, December has almost twice the number of home candle fires compared to an average month. Stay in the room with burning candles. Be sure to snuff out candles before falling asleep, leaving a room, or leaving your home. Burn candles inside a 1 foot circle of safety, giving them ample free space from combustibles. Use candles out of the reach of children and pets. Burn candles on a non-combustible surface, such as a ceramic saucer or plate. 33% of residential fire deaths are caused by carelessly disposed of smoking material, igniting upholstered furniture, mattresses, or bedding, while alcohol use is typically a contributing factor. Be mindful of discarding smoking material safely. Cooking equipment is the leading cause of home fires. Unattended cooking is the principal behavioral factor behind these fires. It is too easy during the holiday season to begin cooking and become distracted with other holiday matters. If you must leave the kitchen, bring a pot holder with you as a reminder of your efforts. If you're using a live Christmas tree this year, install it away from fireplaces, heat sources, and exits. Make certain that the tree stand contains water and is checked daily. We wish you the safe.
All right, we're ready to go. Welcome Welcome back. It's beginning to look and smell a lot like Christmas here in the studio here in Carly and Quincy today, because the ladies of the Wollaston Garden Club have stopped on by to chat with us about their annual holiday greens sale. It's tomorrow from 9 to noon at the Wollaston Congregational Church up on the hill. Please welcome Emily Lebo, Kathy Mead. Ladies, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah, thanks for coming over, and thanks for bringing these gorgeous displays that we're going to talk about, Emily, that are going to be on sale as part of the annual sale tomorrow. It's a big deal for the club.
It's a big deal. It's probably our biggest fundraiser of the year. We've been doing it for 15 years, over 15 years, and it's very popular.
I bet. The club itself is 85 years old?
I think it's 90 next year.
Oh, it is.
From its founding.
Okay.
Yeah, 90 next year.
Incredible. Yeah. Over 100 members.
100 members,
active.
Yeah.
How long have you yourself been involved?
I've just been involved for 2 years. Kathy's a longer term than I am.
Okay. And what was it that attracted you to it?
My husband's a member.
Okay.
And he really enjoys the work part of it.
Yeah.
But not the organizational part of it so much. So he'll do any part of the work. So, and I sort of convinced him to join several years ago.
Oh, all right.
So when I retired, he convinced me to join. So,
oh, all right.
And it's been just a wonderful partnership.
It's a family affair, then.
It is a family affair, yeah.
And it's really a community affair. The club itself is, I mean, we say it's the Wollaston Garden Club, but you are spread out far and wide.
We are. We have a lot of activities going on throughout the city.
Yeah. What are some of your projects that you've completed this year?
This year we had a new one at Atlantic Middle School. So with our civic beautification, that was a horticulture project. We worked with Holly Rendell, who wrote for a grant and received it to put in a garden at Atlantic Middle School. And she also partnered with the Holly Hill Farm Grant that the city had.
Oh, yeah.
So it was really a collaboration between the garden club, the school system, and the grant that the city got.
Okay.
And we put in raised beds. And a lot of planting went on over there. So in education too, we're working with her students. We had guest lecturers go in and work with her students on it. So.
Quite appropriately, coming from the school committee, there has to be an educational element to it, right, Emily?
Right, makes it a lot more fun for us, really, when we do that.
Yeah, I'm sure.
So that was one thing that we started this year. This year also, for the first time, we're going to give scholarships to one student from each of the high schools.
Nice.
Yeah, and someone who's studying either conservation, horticulture or environmental science.
Okay, so I know over at Quincy High they have their rooftop greenhouse there, and they're very involved with the farm to school to table movement.
Right, with
the
culinary
federal
too.
Grant, I think.
Right, they did, and with the culinary arts is working with that too. It's the same thing, so it's great. So we're making those inroads across the city, and we do a lot of civic beautification. Kathy, you can probably talk a little bit better about that than I can.
Including our little garden right outside our front door here
at
the library,
and then at House Neck.
Yep, the library at Housneck.
And then they've also been involved in the Sutter Mill.
Yes.
Sutter Tide Mill.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. So you have your mark across the city then.
Yeah, and we did Safford Park
for
this
Park,
year.
Which
we
is
did a garden.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've seen that new park on Beale Street.
I have, with the new granite benches up there and the beautiful wall that they redid.
It's beautiful.
They have the tree lighting coming up soon, too.
Right. So the garden in the front corner of that, we do.
Okay.
We planted that, planned it, and maintained that garden.
Nice.
And we do something at the Josiah Quincy House, and we also do the Ann Hutchinson Square. We maintain those two properties.
Okay. If somebody wanted to become a member of the Garden Club, how does that happen?
They would get either come to one of the meetings and get an application, or if they knew someone, or they could, we have a website.
Yes, you do, WollastonGardenClub.com.
Which they could go on the website and look there and see what they needed to do.
Okay.
And everyone's welcome.
Okay.
And the meetings are on Thursdays.
Yes, you're the third Thursday of the month, September
through May. It can be evening 6:45 or day 11:45.
Oh, all right.
So, and it changes.
Okay.
It's not, it doesn't alternate,
but
it's kind of even. It evens out with whether it's a day meeting or an evening meeting.
Okay.
And almost all of our meetings are open to the public because we have speakers who come in.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
We had someone to do pruning, yard pruning, who came in September, and actually we gained some members because people from the community came in just to hear that, and then they joined the club, which was pretty cool.
Yeah.
And next month we have...
Local
plantings to attract birds.
Oh, all right.
So if you wanted to have birds come to your, so that's going to be really fun. So those meetings are open.
Okay.
And we had a floral designer in November.
Nice.
That everyone was welcome to come. She was great. Yeah, she did eco-friendly kind of arrangements.
Yeah, every month you've got something different and unique. It's a very active club. I was on your website actually checking it out. And there's always something that would be appealing to anybody. So people ought to check it out. But let's talk about the big event tomorrow. This is your annual Holiday Greens Sale. It's from 9 to noon at the Wollaston Congregational Church. And you brought a few samples,
we
Kathy and Emily, of what we might see tomorrow, including the biggest pine cones I've ever seen in my life. What are those?
One of our members was down south, and she collected these pine cones and decorated them.
Okay. And let's show that to the camera there. Hold it up a little bit higher so folks can see it. And these are how they grow them down South Carolina, did
I guess
you say?
So.
Or I think it was Florida.
Florida?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But she was down south and she was collecting them.
Okay.
So she gets different pine cones, brings them back.
Yeah.
Everybody collects stuff for us for the sale.
All right. So the you're looking out all year long probably for
yes.
Oh, yes.
We're out hunting for friends and neighbors who have friends and neighbors who have evergreens,
uh-huh.
and we gather them. We do not make the wreaths, but we decorate them.
Oh, yeah. All right.
So the wreaths are probably the only thing we actually buy already made.
Okay.
Everything
right.
else is local.
But the pine
and fresh.
Cones, we collect those, and some yep. are some we spray, and some
yep.
we
okay.
just
we
use.
Make all the bows ourselves.
Show that right yeah. to that camera there for folks to see. It's beautiful.
We make all the bows
you
ourselves
make the
too.
Bows. Yep.
Oh
well,
yes, yeah.
yeah.
There's a lot of people with various talent on that on the club.
I
so
would think. Yeah.
We had people out Monday cutting down branches.
Yeah.
All over the city at friends and neighbors' yards who gave us permission.
Okay.
We have 15 different types of greens that we're bagging for people.
Wow.
It's one of our biggest sellers. We give a bag of greens.
Okay.
That people can buy.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's probably our biggest
yeah,
seller. It has holly in it and different types of fern and spruce. It's really beautiful.
Okay, and it'll last all through the winter, really.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, especially if you put it outside.
Right.
They're
right.
for like you
exactly.
know window boxes and outside displays.
Right. So. Right. Emily, you have something next to you that's really unique. That
I do. This
yeah.
is really, really special. This is the first time we've done this. But
yep.
as you know, our club maintains the garden outside, as you said.
Yes, right here at the library.
At
yeah.
the library. That
yep.
We have somebody on the club who planned it and designed it. And the rest of us come and do the work when she tells us what to do, what she wants to do, what she
exactly,
wants planted.
Yeah, watering.
And one of the things that she planted a few years ago was lavender.
Yeah.
So what they did this year is they harvested the lavender that they planted, they planned, they planted, and they maintained,
okay.
and then they harvested it and dried it, and we have these sachets made from the lavender from the library.
And there's a note there explaining exactly
what it is. There is a note saying that.
It
so
is.
It's anybody who buys this supports our work in the garden center, so we'll be selling these also tomorrow. So we have all
Post
different kinds of wreaths.
Mm-hmm.
We have outdoor and indoor displays, arrangements and displays,
yeah.
it's small ones and large ones. We have some very large items. And we have birch, people collect the birch wood.
Yep.
And this is a very small display, but
yeah,
we have.
Yeah, hold it up a little bit for that camera to get a shot at so folks
so
can
yeah,
see
it's a,
it.
This is a fairly small display,
okay.
but we have some very large ones too that you could use outside.
Yes.
And now this is just kind of cute because it's on a miniature log carrier
yeah.
too, so it's really cute. And these things are great for hostess gifts. Like if you're going someplace for Christmas, you can buy something to bring along.
Right, right. But I think the giant pine cones are
They're pretty cool.
And they all, someone also took the larger birch and drilled into it and put a battery-operated candle.
I've seen that
yeah.
done
yeah.
before.
So
it makes a really nice
yeah,
centerpiece.
It was very nice,
yeah,
very nice. Yeah.
What are the funds that are raised from this particular sale used for? Do they go to any specific committee or cause for the
no.
club at all?
No, no. We have probably 12 different committees.
Yeah.
Okay.
Some of the things that we really, well, the programs, we pay for the programs, the experts to come in and,
oh,
and
sure.
run the programs for us once a month, so
yeah.
there's a cost to that. And then we also, the scholarships, and we also do civic beautification. So we've been getting rid of some Japanese knotwood in
oh,
Wollaston.
Okay.
It's
mm.
very
invasive.
It's invasive.
Oh, it
it's very invasive.
Invasive.
We've done some work with pollinators too, with pollinator gardens.
Mm-hmm.
So we support all of those civic beautification sites by buying them, or even more so, we sort of split up our plants
mm-hmm.
and repropagate them ourselves.
Oh, all right.
But the funds go to things like our programs. I would guess would be the biggest expense mm-hmm. we have is the programs, and this year we are going to give the scholarship.
And they do give donations to different groups.
Yeah, so like the
we
South of Tide Mill.
Yeah.
We're members of a lot of groups that we,
yeah,
support.
That we support.
Yeah. Kathy, do you work with other garden clubs in the city at all? You know, there's Howes Neck, there's Squantum, and there's some smaller groups.
Those are the three garden
yeah.
clubs. We have a tri meeting in the
oh,
spring.
Okay.
We get together, but I don't know that we...
I think we do some workshops
we
together
work.
With Housenet.
Yeah, we do
so
workshops. Yeah.
So besides the programs, we might have a workshop on wreath making.
Yes.
And the two clubs will meet together and do that.
Gotcha.
Okay. We're not so much with Squantum, but with Housenet, we have a close relationship.
Right.
But we support their work.
But we
so
do,
whenever
yeah.
they have an event, we make sure we're
right.
there.
Yeah. And I know all the garden clubs are involved in the annual Cleaner Greener
exactly, yeah.
event in the springtime, certainly. That's one of your number one ways to launch the new year every year is participate
right.
in
That's
that.
That's how we start to be outside again.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
Tell me about your garden at home, Kathy. I'm curious. Are you an outdoor gardener, indoor, vegetable, flowers?
I don't have a very large piece of property, and my property has a lot of someone else's trees.
Oh,
so I have a lot of shade.
Okay.
So I have more shade plants.
Okay.
I don't have a vegetable garden.
Okay.
More shade plants, flowers, hydrangeas, peonies, those kind of things.
Okay.
But I don't have a vegetable garden. But now,
Emily, on the other hand.
Yeah. Yeah.
Stu,
her
husband has a vegetable garden.
Okay. Phenomenal.
Give credit where credit
is
due, right?
Yeah.
He has a great vegetable garden. He does a great job outside. He really he loves to be out in the garden working in all of the plants. So he likes different things, you know.
Okay.
So he gets weird hostas and stuff for the garden.
Yeah, she has a beautiful garden.
But this event tomorrow is going to be very popular, so get there early, right?
Oh,
there's a line.
Okay.
They line up very early, and it goes all the way around the corner.
So get there on time or early.
Yeah. Oh, early.
Oh, yeah.
Early.
There are people lined up before we
eight,
open.
8 o'clock.
So you'll be selling out.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We sell out early. Usually between 10:30 and 10:45, most of the stuff is gone.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
WallacenGardenClub.com, your website to go to get more information about the club or the sale itself.
Yep. And we'd love to have people who are interested in membership join. I mean, we're large, but it's a lot of hands. It's like Santa's workshop if you see the stuff they've been doing there this week.
Sure.
Really,
if you could
just
see
crowds of people doing different things.
Well, I hope you have a wonderful event again this year. Thank you both for stopping by, and happy holidays to you.
Thank you.
You too.
You're very welcome. Another quick break on the program. Back with some more community information in just a moment.
The next 30 seconds can save you a lot of money. Just do your laundry in cold and stick to full loads. Auto-sleep your computers. Plug your gadgets in a power strip and switch it off when you're done. Head it out, turn back your thermostat by 10 degrees. And drive sensibly. The more energy you save, the more money you save. Find other great tips at energysaver.gov.
I'm looking for fats, oils, and grease, also known as fog, a.k.a. the blob. Ah! The blob!
Fats, oils, and grease pour down your drain, actually solidify and block your drain from doing its job and connecting to our sanitary sewer system. Once this happens, your drain or toilet can turn against you and back up unsanitary human waste and sludge right back into your home, costing you thousands in repair costs, not to mention a very toxic and unhealthy environment in your own home. Place fats, oils, and grease in a container near your cooking area and let it harden. Then, dispose of the blob safely in your trash where it belongs.
We have a crisis in Massachusetts. Behind closed doors, in every city and town, an epidemic of addiction and overdose, from painkillers to heroin. It usually starts here, where young people find powerful painkillers that can be addictive. For some, the next step may be heroin. It's cheap and everywhere. Tragically, too many lives end behind these doors. If you think, not my kid, think again. To learn more, visit mass.gov/stopaddiction.
Turning colder over the next couple of days. Today's highs up around 50 degrees with plenty of sunshine. A chilly weekend's coming up. It'll be bright tomorrow with highs in the mid-40s, low 40s Sunday, and barely 40 on Monday. Thanks going out to Emily Lebo and Kathy Mead for joining us today from the Wollaston Garden Club. Thank you to our crew, and thank you for watching. On Monday at 11:30, Captain Tim Ross of the Quincy Salvation Army on another live edition of Currently in Quincy. Have a great weekend.